Have a look at this nankata is so beautifully baked, right? Now I can only make and show you, but if you need to taste them, you have to do it on your own. So sharing the recipe is all about inspiring others to cook. So come on guys, try this nankata recipe. Let's see how we go about doing it. Hello friends, a warm welcome to Family Recipe Girl. Today let's learn how to make Narayan Katar, that is naan katai. So let's quickly check out the ingredients that goes into making it. First I have 1 1/4 cups of maida, 3/4 cup of ghee, 1 cup powder sugar, 3/4 teaspoon cooking soda or baking soda, a fistful of cashew bits, this is optional, kesar infused milk, I've just taken 1 tablespoon of milk, and then elaichi or cardamom powder, very little. And now let's go on to making it. Now as you can see, I have mixed ghee, baking soda, and then kesar and elaichi. Now after giving it a quick mix, we'll add cashew. Mixing it now. Now if you don't have kesar at home, you can always use 1/4 teaspoon of haldi, 1/4 to 1/2 teaspoon. That will also give you a beautiful yellow color. Now I'll add the cashew and then maida and sugar. I'll first add the sugar, give it a good mix, and then add maida. They are well mixed now. Now in goes the maida. Mix this also very well. Now you can see that my maida is well mixed. Your hands of course are the best tools. So just give it a good mix and then make balls out of it. You should be able to bring the dough together like this. And the ghee will be sufficient. Suppose you feel you are not able to make balls out of this mixture, then you can add 1 tablespoon more ghee. It's easily made into a ball. Now after making a ball, just flatten it a little. It might break. So you can add 1 more tablespoon of ghee. Just gently press it with your fingers like this. Can you see that? So that's sufficient. And now I have my trays ready here. I've just greased them with butter and dusted with maida. And I'll just arrange them on it like this. And do the rest of them. Now you can see that my OTG is preheating for 10 minutes. After the right temperature is reached, we'll just keep our nankatais inside. Now while placing these nankatais on the tray, you must remember that you need to space them out because after baking, they'll increase in size. Now 3 batches are up and ready, and this will go into a microwave oven just to show you how to bake it in a oven in convection mode. Now dusting the tray simply means brushing the tray with butter and then sprinkling maida on it and dusting off the excess maida. Then the tray will be ready to be placed with the nankatais. I have placed a tiny bit of cashew on each nankatai just for the eye appeal. Now my oven is hot enough for the nankatais to go in. I'll just push the nankatai tray inside. Remember that the nankatai should always be placed in the center rack of your OTG. Gently close the door and then bake it at 180 degrees for 15 to 18 minutes. But please check in between. You need to check at 15 minutes because cookies, you should remember, will be soft and crumbly. But once you pull them out of the OTG, they will harden upon standing. So if it is a little soft, it is okay. See how beautifully they are being done. We had actually made rounds of it and lightly flattened it. Now they have flattened so much and bigger in size. Now the naan kata is done. I'll just remove them out. Have a look. Wow! Just look at them. Such a beauty, isn't it? I'll just quickly push the second one inside. Again in the center rack. Keep them in the center. Close the door and continue. Such a beauty, isn't it? You will love tasting them too. They'll be equally awesome, if not more. And now we'll wait for this to cool down before we can dig into them. Now I really can't wait to show you how it is done. Just check the texture, see? Look at the back side. Crisp and lovely. It is still hot, but I just wanted to show you. I will wait for it to cool sufficiently before I'll break it and show you. Now compare the two. This was how it was when I kept it inside, and this is how it is now. Now just to let you know how to bake naan katais in a microwave oven in convection mode, I'll show you one batch in this. So for this we need to auto heat the oven. This is the option. So press this once, and you need to adjust the temperature to 200 because when you open the door it tends to cool down the temperature inside, and then press the button. So let's wait for it to preheat and then we'll put the naan katai inside. Now my microwave is sufficiently preheated. It's giving me a countdown of 10 minutes before I can keep the naan katai inside. So let's stop it, open the door and quickly place our naan katai inside. Close the door and then stop it. Now this is the convection mode on. Now you need to press it. As you press it, the temperature changes. Now you keep it at 180 degrees and then give the timing. That will be 18 minutes. Now put it on. Now it will get done within 18 minutes. Now we can see that it stopped. The naan katais are done. Remove them out. And you can see them beautifully done. Let's check it out. So this is the one done in a microwave convection oven. And this was done in a, it was done in an OTG. Now my second set of OTG naan katais are also done. Let me remove them out and place it on a cooling rack. So here we go. Ta-da! All three beautifully baked. See? Yahoo! Now have a look. This has completely cooled. Just have a look at the texture. It's very crumbly. And let me break it for you. Ooh, look at the hollow structure inside. This is how it should be baked. This is perfectly done. And you love eating them. Now let me show you how the microwave cookies have been done. Just see. This is also crumbly. This is also got the hole in the center. And both the sets of naan katais are beautifully done. So guys, please go ahead and try this. And I'm sure all the ingredients are easily available at home. You can downsize it if you don't have so much of ingredients. Like 1 cup is, maida is not a big issue, but ghee definitely will be. So you can keep one small katori as a measuring unit, and accordingly you can make your Nankatize. Downsize it and make it proportionately. So please give it a thumbs up if you like this recipe and share it with your family and friends. Thank you.